They are skillful.
If you had to pick a favorite, which would it be?
There's Brachiosaurus and Stegosaurus and Apatosaurus. Allosaurus!
Hello, art family, and thank you to all the new subscribers. So for this demo, I decided to do a sketch from the Natural History Museum in Pittsburgh. This is the Allosaurus dinosaur, which is my son's favorite. We go there a lot. I start off by knocking back the white of the page. We're working on a 7x10 hot pressed paper here from Arches. This is a block actually, so it's glued around the edges to keep it from curling. These pages will still curl on you though when you peel it out of the block, so I recommend considering getting a matching hardboard or some kind of hard surface that you can roll some non-pH, non-yellowing glue on and affix this to a panel if you want to keep it or sell it. Otherwise you can just kind of let them pile up, but they will curl on you if you don't get it in a frame or something. That's why I usually work on crescent illustration board, because it's much thicker and it won't really curl on you so much. So I start by knocking away the white of the page just to get some sort of something down, some underpainting to build on top of. I used a lavender and blue in the background with some yellow ochre around the objects of interest, just to have something shine through the little pockets and spaces where I don't fully paint through. That's also why I draw using a pink gouache and a round brush. I did the drawing trying to think gesturally about the skeleton of the Allosaurus, and also about these moments of rhythm throughout the whole image. So where does the tail touch other objects, and then if I were to draw a straight line across the dinosaur, where does it touch? You know, I see the large dinosaur off to the right has a tail that hits the hip structure of the Allosaurus, and I can look at that and go straight up and down too and find some plumb lines vertically as well. I'm placing in some values, but I know I need a darker value and something in the background that I can then negative paint these shapes. I'm going to try to think of this dinosaur like it's basically a ball of clay that I'm cutting away form, just thinking of the major shapes of value. I'm also thinking about the whole sketch that way, taking a step back, closing one eye and squinting at the reference, and considering the broad, large shapes of value. There's a dark shape of value behind the Allosaurus. It's nice to have that knocked in so that when I get to the Allosaurus, I can negative paint in the shapes as I go, correcting the drawing and filling in areas if I need to. I think when you go about a sketch, you have to think about what's important to you about the sketch, what you're trying to achieve with the sketch, your sort of goal to chase after. And for me, it's more about the atmosphere. I think some people are really, I love dinosaurs. I'm really into dinosaurs, but I'm not really particularly into detail of objects that I sketch. It could be a plant or a bowl of, you know, food. I don't pay that much attention to what the object is. In fact, I try very hard to forget what the object is or not pay attention to what the object is, because I don't want my brain to go into autopilot mode and try to draw some kind of caricature of what I think the object is. So I try to just think about these broad chunks of value. I don't consider these figures as much as these planes and facets and forms that I can place, looking for the lighter and the darker value. I also considered saturation, because even though we're indoors and I'm fairly close to this skeleton, I want to make sure that the saturation of the foliage on that back wall is less intense, less colorful. So I want the brighter greens to be closer to me. So it'll help give that sense or the illusion of depth, hopefully, when you take a step back from the sketch. So I'm breaking the dinosaur down. Now that I have the drawing as I like it and the broad shapes down, I've got this sort of neutral gray that I'm putting in. And we have a lot of skylight, so there's quite a bit of cool light hitting the top surfaces of everything. There's a little bit of warm light coming in through the window that kind of rakes across through the upper left area, but most of the room is light that's bouncing all around. So I'm not too concerned about having a very hard, warm area and a very stark, cool shadows. It's mostly sort of light bouncing all around the room I'm still going to close one eye though and squint at the reference and just try to break this down, boil it down to its most simple arrangement of shapes. It's important to have those darks in the background, and I need to add some to the bottom left. As you can see, it's much darker in the reference as it is in the sketch, and I need these dark pockets within the dinosaur skeleton as well, because a beginner mistake is if you keep everything within that higher kind of range of values and you don't really plumb down deep for the darker bits of value, you can end up with a sketch that tends to look kind of bleached out and very kind of light. So what I like to do, and sometimes if I'm sketching I'll even use black, but very rarely, I'll typically go for an even mixture of ultramarine and burnt umber that I will vary between the two. So I'll mix the puddle and shift the left half or so to be more ultramarine blue, the right half to be a little bit more brown, burnt umber, or burnt sienna, more orangey. And when I'm doing a dark area, to maintain that kind of seasoning for the sketch or that kind of color character, I will go back and forth between the warm and the cool constantly. I do that pretty much for any shape I'm putting in. I'm always constantly shifting just a little bit from warm to cool to warm to cool. But you can see now the bottom looks a little bit bleached out. So in order to get these figures placed and correct, I need to get that darker value down there to start to realize this kind of, to have something to compare it to, right? Because value is always comparative. We see things that are light because of the dark or dark because of the light. So we have to have those things together in order for it to really read clearly. Even with the faces in the scene, I'm not terribly concerned with the detail or the accuracy of it. I'm mostly looking for that silhouette of the shape. I want to put in a large, kind of fairly neutral area, although I'm pitching it much more saturated and kind of pinkish reddish because it's flesh, and I want to make sure that even though it's in my sketching personal goal and style, it's going to be very loose and more focused on the silhouette and broad shapes than a detailed accurate rendering of the specifics. But I'm still going to get those in and break those shapes down in value. And now I can use the ground behind it to negative paint in the structure of the figures and try to get them a little bit more accurate. Now I'm just knocking out any of the white areas because I feel more confident in the overall sketch. You know, I don't feel like I have to throw this one out, and I can see it all the way through. So at this point I have my broad, large shapes in and as I like them to be, and as I say in a lot of these videos, this last little bit of time you could take forever on and just continue noodling away at the detail until you had a very accurate rendering. I'm not as interested in that. My goal is more to create the atmosphere of that room and, you know, seeing this large dinosaur skeleton. So that's going to be it for this demo. I hope you got a lot out of it. Of course, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching.